Hi there, my beautiful family. We're back again on the channel Africa Unity platform. My name is King Idris and I'm here again to give you people more good insight on what is going on the African soil and the international community. Today we're back again with the prominent one, my people. We're talking about our own beloved sister Afrique, Banjo. You know, she won straight A's in On Our Heck in Nigeria. She's a Nigerian. She rose to prominence in year 2000, in year 2020, when she won straight A's in On Our Heck. You know, she claimed everything and cleared the result. You know, she is a daughter of another prominent teacher, whereby she had a lot of experience in the academic subject. You know, she did a lot of beautiful, wonderful job, whereby now she had permanent scholarship everywhere in the United States, world of in the overall world. It's not only United States, in Canada, in Britain, in some place in Nigeria, and in the United States, worth of $5 million. Everything put together, all the scholarship put together, is worth of $5 million, my people. This is a good win for Nigeria. This is a beautiful one for Africa. So we're going deep on this. She won this scholarship whereby of yearly. So my people, is a very beautiful news in Nigeria. A lot of people in Nigeria have been reacting to this, and a lot of people in Africa have been, you know, wishing Nigerian better things on the internet. Even my beautiful people from Ghana and Cameroon, you know, the 17-year-old school graduate was offered more than 15 million, more than 5 million up to $15 million worth of scholarship. So Afrique Banjo was given potential full scholarship from Ivy College schools, Yale schools, Princeton University, Harvard University, and Brown University, even John Hopkins University and the University of Virginia gave her the scholarship. Even in Canada, Lester B. Pearson Scholarship from the University of Toronto, and Karen McLean, International Leader of Tomorrow, KMILOT, also gave her this scholarship, and also from the University of British Columbia gave her the scholarship too. You know, she was born in Nigeria, in Lagos, Nigeria, to the beautiful parent of her parent, Chika Yinka Banjo, and his father is his, the mom is a senior lecturer at the University of Lagos, and the father, Yinka Banjo, is a procurement and a supply chain executive. You know, this is the unity we've seen on this platform. You can see a Yibo woman and a Yoruba man blend up together with a lot of unity, and you see what come out, beautiful flower of excellence, and you know, one of the best student in Nigeria and one of the best student in Africa. So she cleared all the A's in our WAEC, you know, in the African WAEC, my people. This is what we're saying. So a lot of things have been going on this, and a lot of people have been speaking out their mind, because they said, why would the people in the schools in the Western countries give her this scholarship? They're trying to steal her away. No, my people, there's nobody that see better things and good things than won't venture to it. Like, they saw the future of this beautiful lady, and they saw the goodness she can contribute to the international community and to the people in the Western world, you know. And it's gonna be a good gain for the people, and the people of African soil, mostly people of Nigeria, because this is what we're saying. Like, it's all about unity, it's all about togetherness, it's all about moving forward, it's all about doing the right thing. So Afrique Banjo have already make everyone proud as a Nigerian, and she had did the best of that, the best of the best, the best she can do for herself and for the people of the African soil. So she had an interview with BBC where she said she have to read, because she never believed all this school took her into their school can easily give her the scholarship or give her acceptance to their school, because she had to the exam and the process to get into their school is too said to get into their school is too extreme. So she has to do everything she can to get into the school. She has to read every day, she has to put in a lot of great work, a lot of great work, you know. And she had a lot of people like putting her through to in her education, like she put in all her best, and now she achieved this. So my people, is a beautiful one, is a beautiful one to our sister from the beautiful country of Nigeria. She's doing the best, and she's making the Nigerian people proud, and she's flying the flag high, you know. So on the the other side, we'll be moving on to another topic. We'll be talking about the bandit, terrorist bandit, putting out their flag in the Niger state, you know, and they are trying to like tell the people like they are here to stay. So the Nigerian government have already moving massively to put an end to this, and they are doing a lot of house cleaning, you know, taking care of what they need to take care of, you know, doing the right thing for the people. And the people can easily see all this, and they're happy for what the president of Nigeria are doing for them. And now they have already pushed the bandit out of the state, you know, brought some stability to the people in the region and some calmness. They just want them to be all right and make things work fine for the people. So this is what we're saying. Nigeria is going through a lot, and you can see our own sister Afica Banjo in the other side trying to make the people of Nigeria smile, put the name of Nigeria out to the people in the international world in a better way. You know, this is what we're saying. Like, I'll just say on this platform, I'm pleading to the president of Nigeria, even me myself coming out every day to talk about this insurgency unrest in Nigeria. I'm tired of it. You know, it's just for them to find solution to what is going on in Nigeria and put everything right to the right place in Nigeria where things are supposed to be. And you can see the beautiful of Nigeria start to getting flourish and getting to get the right recognition they need to get in the international community, because we have a lot of gifted people, a lot of respected people, a lot of blessed people in Nigeria, you know, with a lot of talent, you know, a lot of things, like a lot of talent are dying every day in Nigeria. So because of the instability and what the government are doing to the people, so I'll be coming to an end of this segment today. Just a good one to celebrate our own sister Fitri Banjo, you know, to tell her that don't stop, keep pushing for the African people, keep pushing for the Nigerian people, and keep pushing for the future of Africa. On this platform, I'll be coming to an end today. On this segment today, we'll be coming back with another content on this platform today. But now is a quick one. I'll be saying kudos to my new subscribers, kudos to the people I've been working with me. One Africa, one people, one unity. Thank you.